going to double check with Brian that he's aware that... Good afternoon and welcome. Thank you for being here today. My name is Jenny Gibbs. I'm a funeral celebrant who's been asked to lead the service for you. You are met here today to honour the life of Brenda Jane Rice. Today is an opportunity to join in taking leave of someone who has been loved and respected. We will remember the life that Brenda has lived, and it's an opportunity to hear some of the story of the life that she led and to reflect on her uniqueness and special qualities. You have all come here today to give thanks for knowing Brenda and to express gratitude for the days and years and times that you shared with her. We're here to remember a very special and very much loved person. By remembering her best, you will cement the memory of her within you, and that will never leave you. It is hoped that the service today serves to comfort her family and all of you here. On behalf of the family, I would like to open up the service today by delivering the eulogy, Brenda's story, that her family have written in her honour. Life started for Brenda when she was born prematurely at the St Helier Hospital, Carshorton, on the 25th of October 1953. Brenda was the youngest but one of seven children born to parents Peggy and Ken Davey. Her brothers and sisters are Carol, Robin, Susan, Christine, Rosemary, Brenda, and Kenneth. Brenda spent her childhood living with her family in a prefab before moving to a three-bedroom house in Morden. Brenda shared a bedroom with her four sisters and was blessed that they are a very close family, and Brenda had a very happy and loving childhood. When she left school, she trained as a hairdresser and worked in Merton High Street, just opposite where her sister Christine lived. Christine had just had a baby boy, Mark, and in her lunch times, Brenda would call in to have a cuddle. Invariably, he would be sick on her, and she had to smother herself in perfume before going back to work. In 1972, Brenda met her future husband, Brian Rice. They met in Tiffany's in Wimbledon. They went on a date, and when she arrived home, she told her sister, Rosemary, that she was going to marry him. And she did, on the 7th of June, 1975. They moved to Greenford in Middlesex and then moved again to Yateley in Hampshire in 1988 to a beautiful house which Brenda loved. In December 1977, her little soldier Billy arrived. And then on the 17th of June 1980, her beautiful daughter Carla made an appearance. Her family was now complete. Brenda was very family orientated. She adored her husband, Brian, and her children. Brenda had a beautiful smile and was extremely popular and was loved by everyone that knew her. In her younger days, Brenda loved to play netball and had quite a talent as a goal shooter. Many of her friends she got to meet through playing netball. She also enjoyed attending football with Brian, Billy, and Carla. They watched Queen's Park Rangers. However, there wasn't any choice in team selection as Brian had followed QPR since a small lad. When Billy and Carla were younger, Brenda's weekends were filled with taking Carla to dancing lessons all day Saturday and then on Sunday watching Billy play football in all weathers. In 1991, her mum Peggy died. And then in 1993, she lost her dad. Brenda and the family were all devastated. On the 18th of November 2009, her grandson Charlie Rice was born, followed shortly after by Molly on the 14th of March 2011. To say she adored her grandchildren was an understatement. She lived for her family and friends. She was also very popular with the family dogs, Rocky and Teddy. As Brenda got older, she got to enjoy some lovely short breaks to Dublin with her daughter Carla, sisters Rosemary and Susan, niece Shelley and her friends, many of whom she met whilst working at GSI ADP. And had all remained great friends ever since. The stories they would tell had you laughing for years. Sad times were to come when she lost her brother-in-laws, Christopher and Alec, sister Rosemary, and then last year her brother Robin. Brenda was devastated. After the loss of Alec, Brenda spent lovely times with her sister Carol, going to stay the night. Often they would sit up and talk until the early hours of the morning, putting the world to rights. Brenda and Brian had 45 wonderful years of marriage together, enjoying lots of great holidays, and Brian was with Brenda until the very end. Our lovely Brenda didn't have a bad bone in her body. She was as beautiful inside as out. And that's why she is so loved by so many. Brenda will be deeply missed and always remembered by all who knew and loved her. Rest in peace, Brenda. We're now going to hear memories of our mum, and I'd like to ask Billy and Carla to come up.
So thank you for coming. I just wanted to run through some really lighter stories about my mum, and hopefully people can view it on the internet as well. My mum had a very special quality, one that's really often overlooked, and that was that she was nice. Whenever my mum's name came up in conversation, they would always comment how lovely she was, or they'd just seen her at Waitrose more often than not. I don't think I ever met anyone who disliked my mum. She was truly special, and she would do anything to help anyone in need. And you could see that just by looking through her Facebook feed. It was full of candles for cancer victims, slogans about how much she loved her grandchildren, and saying how great NHS nurses were. For someone who wasn't really a fae with the latest technology, she was a bit of a Facebook stalker. Whenever I posted a picture on Facebook, normally of her grandchildren, Charlie and Molly, my notifications would light up. Brenda Rice likes this photo. Brenda Rice likes this photo. Brenda Rice likes this photo, and so on and so on. Nothing was too much trouble for my mum. As a child, I was a little bit on the large side. I was a little bit chubby. I can't remember the exact circumstances, but at the age of 5, for some reason, I was having tap dancing lessons. My mum would come in and watch me, but before long, the teacher had to pull her aside and ask her to leave, as all she was doing was laughing hysterically at me. She also laughed hysterically at me when I was the golden goose in the school play, so I think there was a bit of a running theme. My mum was also the only person in the world to have a full-on conversation with a voicemail. Quite often, I'd be left a message on my phone. Hi, Billy, how are you? Pause. Hope you're okay. Are the kids all right? Pause. Dad's been watching the football. Have you? Pause. Then she'd forget to hang up and go about her normal day all the time left on my voicemail. For anyone who knows my family, we're all very big QPR supporters. So my mum was delighted when, I think my early 20s, I got a job working for QPR. And at one time, QPR, they were going for promotion up in Sheffield, and I was there working, and my dad and my sister went to the game, and it was a very important game because we had to win to get promoted. And my mum went to watch the game at Loftus Road Stadium, which is QPR's home ground. She went to watch it on a big screen with several thousand QPR friends, QPR fans and Nicola Humphreys. Happily for us, Rangers won that day and got promoted. So we were all very excited. And after the game, I was chatting to our chief executive. He wasn't too happy, mutterings expletives under his breath. He said that the fans at Loftus Road had invaded the pitch and they had to stop the broadcast early. Whilst I understood how happy they must have been, I nodded along with him and said how terrible it was that they all invaded the pitch. Just then my phone rang, and it was my mum. She went, "Hi Billy, it's Mum, guess what? I'm on the pitch." another story my dad reminded me of was the day he received a text from my mum in the early evening whilst he was still at work. It said, "I've been in A&E since 2 o'clock. My dad, very concerned, replied, "Why?" And she said, "There's been a really big queue." my dad, my sister and I can be quite loud, especially after a few glasses of wine. And when you add to the mix my wife, my children, our two dogs, things could get a bit manic at family get-togethers. And normally we'd all be very talking quite loudly, taking the mickey out of each other, or watching my daughter Molly sing Let It Go. My mum normally wouldn't get too involved, but she'd sit there with a big smile on her face, just happy, enjoying the time with her family. It was always a private joke in our family that I was a little soldier, and whenever I would visit, I would get special treatment. When she was in hospital, on the many medications they were taking effect, I would talk to her and try to remind her who I was. On one occasion, I asked her who I was, and I said, "Hey, Mum, it's Billy. Do you remember what you call me?" She beckoned me closer and she whispered, "Little bastard." So I hope she was joking. As you get older, it's easy to take your parents for granted. The nights they stayed up because you had whooping cough, The late night pickups, the hours standing on the side of freezing football pitches or dancing competitions. My sister and I were truly blessed to have our mum. I know my mum's life wasn't as long as we would have wanted, but she gave myself and my sister a very happy childhood and a great start in life. She had a husband who she adored, even if he was the only person ever to have a full-blown fight with a Christmas tree. She was very close to her brothers and sisters, her nieces and nephews, and all her extended family. She also had many great friends. There were even whispers that on some of these gatherings she would be up on dancing on tables. I don't think my mum would be doing that. Finally, I think you all agree that my mum was loved. She was kind, she was loving and generous, and she will leave a massive void in the lives of her family and friends. But she'll always be loved and always be remembered.
Our house was a happy home and a very welcoming one. Our house was always the meet point for pre-drinks before the pub with my friends. Dad would be topping up everyone's Prosecco and Mum would be preparing some nibbles in the kitchen. You would often find my mum singing and dancing in the kitchen, especially to her favourite music, Tamla Motown. I have such wonderful memories of summer nights in our back garden, and more often than not, we never made it to the pub. Mummy was everything to me, my best friend, my keeper of secrets, my strength, my partner in crime, my supporter, my comforter, and my broken heart healer. Mummy's spirit, sense of humour, bravery and courage were remarkable right up until the very end. Even on the darkest of days, she would find a way to make us smile and laugh. I'd like to thank my dad for always caring for my mum and always being right by her side to the very end. My lasting memories of Mummy are simple. A caring, compassionate, selfless woman of courage who never waned in her support or love of her family and who soldiered on when times were tough. Mummy, your wings were ready, but my heart was not. A mother is she who can take the place of all others, but whose place no one else can take. There is not a day that will pass that I will not love and miss you. Good night, Mummy, I love you.
We're now going to take some time for reflection. Time for you all to think of some of your own special thoughts that you have of Brenda. Whilst we do, we're going to listen to Ain't No Sunshine by Bill Withers. On behalf of Brian, I'd now like to deliver a poem that he has chosen for Brenda. It's called To the One I Love. They say memories are golden. Well, maybe that is true. I never wanted memories. I only wanted you. A million times I needed you. A million times I cried. If love alone could have saved you, you never would have died. In life I loved you dearly. In death I love you still. In my heart you hold a place no one can ever fill. If tears could build a stairway, and heartache make a lane, I'd walk the path to heaven to bring you home again. Our time on earth has ended and nothing seems the same. But when God calls me to be with you, our love will live again. It is now time to say a final farewell to Brenda with deep love and respect for this unique person. Would you please stand? As we commit the body of Brenda Jane Rice, commit to your hearts your precious memories of her. Brenda, we thank you for being the person that you were. We thank you for your kindness, compassion, and the dedication you've given to life. We thank you for the bravery and strength you have shown. We thank you for the wonderful memories you leave behind. Until we meet again, take with you the love of those who will always love you. The story of your life will remain in the memories of those who will never forget you. And rest peacefully for all eternity. In sorrow we bid you farewell. With love we leave you in peace. May you rest in eternal peace. Please be seated. You have all come here today to say goodbye to Brenda and to acknowledge some of those thoughts and feelings that well up in us when we are saddened by the death of someone that we have loved. But sadness is not your only emotion, as you were all a big part of her life, just as she was a big part of your lives. So always remember her with kindness, with warmth, with fond memories, with love and affection, and above all with gratitude for all those wonderful memories she leaves in your lives. Thank you.